Hello, I'm Mixed Mars and Merman, and welcome to my channel. On today's video, we'll be with Alec Kensington 20K. If your Alec Kensington or Acrobat model has a belt issue, whether the belt is slipping, the belt has snapped, or you just want to change the belts, you can do this at home very, very quickly with minimal tools and minimal effort. If this is your first time watching Mixed Mars and Merman, hit the old subscribe button, whack the old bell, set your notifications to all. That way, you'll be told next time I upload another video. So, without further ado, let's get down dirty and let's get this belt changed on this lovely little Alec Kensington. Okay, so the first thing to do, I just want to swing the Alec round the other way. As I say, these do also fit on the ATCO bound models. They're the same. The Quokar cylinder mowers, they're the same. Pretty much any cylinder mower that's got, which is belt driven and cylinder driven via belts, then this video could be the one for you. Let me get you repositioned and I'll show you how quick and easy it is. Okay, to work on this machine, first of all, you need to just pull off your HT lead, which is located on top of a spark plug. Just pull that off so the machine cannot fire, because you need to have make sure safety is first. And whilst you're mucking about the machine, you need to make sure that the engine doesn't start up by mistake. Then with an Allen key, just simply put it inside. There's four bolts to undo. One. Two. Three. And then the last one down the bottom. Once the four bolts have been undone, you can then slowly retract the side inspection cover and put that down to one side. Tip it upwards so you don't lose your bolts on your lawn, because you took four bolts out, you want to make sure those four bolts go back in. Let me get repositioned, I'll show you how to remove these belts. Okay, so to remove the belts, the first belt here, which is a front one, the other belt is behind. The first belt is your cylinder belt, which comes off of the output shaft around this front pulley, and then comes down onto this pulley, which then transfers onto a set of gears beneath, and then will then transfer the drive from the belt to a cog to your cylinder. To remove this this first belt, all you have to do is a little tiny 10mm bolt just here, and just loosen that off, and there'll be a washer associated with that. Remove the 10mm bolt, and then just slide out this pulley cover. Take that out. And then on this machine, this pulley will actually just retract all the way out. And you can retract this with the belt still in place. Out it comes. Just retrieve it off of the pulley. Make sure it's the right way up, because the gear is on the back. And then you can just remove that belt just like so. So that's the first belt. Put that to one side. And then the second belt is just slightly more tricky, but it's perfectly doable. Okay, next thing, you can either use a 19mm spanner, or you can use a 19mm impact. Now, they're not on there super duper tight, so we'll try it. First of all, just a 19mm spanner, see if we can do it, because obviously not everyone's going to have an impact. And these are normal threaded. The problem being is you're going to have to try and stop this from turning. That's the hardest issue, okay? That's why I use an impact. Put it on there, hold a pulley, give it a little tiny tap, and then that nut will then just retract. Otherwise, you've got to try and hold a pulley at the same time. On some models, you've got a little tiny hole on the top of these, but this one doesn't actually have it. Once you remove that top pulley, then you can then, there's a few collars, and this pulley here separates, okay? But what you can then do is just slacken off the belt, and it will come all the way off, and then comes your belt. Your belt comes off. Now, if you're looking for the information for the belts, you can find the information on some belts, which will be written on the side wall. This one is slightly rubbed off, but this one is okay. So this is an A57941, which would be your cylinder, and this one's unlegible, this one here. But if I find the links to the belts, I'll leave them in the description down below. Once you've removed your belts and you've got your new set of belts in your packet, you can then get your drive belt. As I say, I'll leave the comments section where you can find the new belts, links for those. Just slide your belt on a top pulley, then slide it on the bottom, and then all you have to do is just tease it up and then push that split pulley closed, okay? Because that pulley completely separates. What you don't want to be doing is having this pulley in like so and then squeeze that up, because that belt will then get pinched up the top, you see? What you want to be doing is just tease that pulley out, push the belt all the way up, and then close that pulley up as far as it will go, so that the belt actually sits on the top of the pulley housing, okay? Once that's done, you can then get your top pulley, slide it into position, get your washer and your 19mm nut, slide that on, hold the pulley gently, mind your fingers, and just a couple of nicks is all it needs. It doesn't need to be done up super duper tight, okay? Once that one's now in place, you can then grab your bottom cylinder pulley, one we had beforehand. You can slide that just roughly, loosely on over the top pulley, the one which you just put on, and then just negotiate it over onto the cylinder pulley and just give it a little tiny bit of a turn. As you turn it, it will just feed itself in onto one, and then just turn that pulley around and it just slip on. So one important note to make here is that when this cylinder pulley goes on, it must be inside these two little tiny pins, which are called pulley guides or belt guides. It must be on the inside. It can't be on the outside, otherwise you'll get far too much tension like that. Okay, so it's going to cause tension. So make sure that both these pulleys are both on the inside. And this is why it's important, because you're rotating the engine, to actually have the spark plug removed. Just double check before you put it all back together is that the cylinder pulley is on the inside of the two belt guides, and it is resting on the inside here of this tensioner pulley, and on the drive pulley it comes straight down and it is resting on this side of the tensioner pulley for the drive. Once that's all in place, you can then just put your pulley cover back on, and that's that little tiny 10mm nut bolt, sorry, with a very, very nice little couple of washers on there. Feed that into place, and then that just gets up, done up snug, nice and snug. It doesn't have to be super duper tight. There you go. Once you've done that, you can then grab your side inspection cover, and you should have all four bolts. Gentle tap, and then do up your four remaining bolts. Just like so. So there you go, quick little video on how to change your cylinder belt and your drive belt on your Alec Kensington, your Alec machines, or your Atco Bauer mowers, or indeed your Crowcast mowers for that. They're all pretty much the same and interchangeable. Down in below in the comment section and in my description, you'll find the links to some of the belts you can buy for these. I'll try and put genuine ones on if I can, because that way there'll be no confusion as to which belt you need. Sometimes you need to just change the cylinder belt or the drive rather than just changing the pair. It all depends on the failure that you have with your machine. If you enjoy this sort of video for Mixed Mud and Merman, hit the subscribe button, whack the old bell, set notifications to all. That way you'll be told next time I'll have another video. I look forward to seeing this episode of Mixed Mud very, very soon, but until then, guys and girls, much more importantly, take care easy.